Hello everyone, welcome back to Natalia, Lovecraft Forever channel, and I am showing you my workspace, guys. This is where I work on all my magic, my computer, and here's the desk that I work most of the time, so it's kind of comfortable. I work in here and then I watch YouTube video, my friends, and reviewing my own channel. So today we are going to talk about cross stitching and have some questions that I would love to answer today for you about cross stitching, about canvases. And I guess it gets sometimes confusing the way I record the video and what you see. As you can see, my tripod stays right next to window, and I put my project in here, for example this cross stitch. So what you see my project when I do and stuff from this angle, okay? If my camera on my tripod, you see project upside down. So it's kind of backwards to you. And sometimes it's a little bit confusing maybe on what I'm doing. So my question was about, and thank you for concerning about me, because when I was doing counted cross stitching, my lovely friend subscriber was concerned if I'm not doing a mistake by reading my symbols. No, I did writing, and I'm gonna show you right now how I did. And sorry if you hear my son talking downstairs on his video games. I hope you can hear me. So here's how kind of I'm going to show you how I organized my cross stitching, new cross stitching that we did just started with you. I bought this container from Walmart. It's comfortable because it has locks on both sides and a handle to move away. So I put in here my stuff, which is my tools, everything I need up there. I have my stitch canvas in here that we just started with you. Okay, I did not do much without you. I was working a little bit on this winter one today and yesterday. So I have in here my icons, what I need to do, anyway, you know what it is. So in here my all the threads and everything what I need with this particular cross stitching. So what I want to point it out, if I put this box a little bit aside in here, and if I would open my canvas, I'm gonna take away tripod for now. Okay, just a minute. Okay, so what you were seeing me cross stitching, you were seeing me working upside down this way. So I was sitting on the other side of the table and stitching towards you. So now I'm gonna show you the way I see. So here is was my marking that we look with you. Okay, so we was doing a mark with those pins. When I wash my canvas, those holes will disappear. But here it is, I started from this side. And those stitches looks pretty even. It's good, I think. And now the question was if I'm doing in a wrong position of my stitching and counting. So I'm gonna show you this piece of page that I have all the symbols, and you will see that I am doing right. So this is my bottom page, and that's what we doing right now. Okay, so I'm counting from my right bottom corner, and that's how I start my canvas. And because the picture is longer this way, so this is my horizontal position of the canvas, and center of the canvas will be in here, and this picture will be on both sides, end up like, you know, somewhere in here. So same distance from this side will be same distance left from this side. So that's why you need to find your center, so you have same frame kind of empty around of your canvas and picture would be exactly on the center. Now my question also was, why didn't I start on the middle, right? So this is totally your preference, the way you like it. And let me just fold it in half so it's kind of like a shorter canvas. You can start, pretend this is the just a square of the canvas and not folded. So I like to start my canvas on the bottom right corner and I'm go from right stitch to the left. If I start from the center, I can do this way, but then if I go from center to this side, I will have to twist my arm or something else because I don't do stitches this way and go back in the same way. I do from here. Okay, so for me to start from center wouldn't be not comfortable to go this way, only one way. So that's why I always start or on the bottom, or I can do from the top, but it's still from my corner because I right-handed and I stitch from right to left, not from top to the bottom or from the bottom to the top that some people make in the stitches this way first. My goal this way. So that's the only thing. This is your preference, how you want to start your stitching. I see many girls starting stitches from top left corner and go diagonally, or go this way and then go this way, right? So it's depends how comfortable for you. There's many ways you can start. You can make horizontal, you can have a vertical, you can start from the center and go on each way the way you're comfortable. But because I do not have frame for the cross stitch, I'm holding my canvas in my hands all the time, so it's not comfortable for me would be go to the other side, because I would have to like twist my, for example, here is my right hand. I would have to twist it to go the other way. That wouldn't be work for me. So this position of the needle from right corner to the left, that's the way I work because it's comfortable for me. So you always pick your way, what is comfortable for you, so you can do your cross stitches. Now also I have a question, and that would be I think I already answered from which side is best to do cross stitching. Yes, it's whatever comfortable for you. If you are left-handed, probably would be better for you to start from left corner, but the way I measure my canvas from center, you can start your first cross stitch right in here and go from there. For me, I found center, so I know if I count this way and this way, I will have same measurements left from all the sides. From four sides, I will have a same distance, and as you can see, it will be the same distance, okay, from all four corners. Okay, now the other one question I had, what the difference between Ada of the sizing? So let me put my camera on a tripod and so I can have a two hands available, and I will show you what's the difference. And this is for beginners who don't know really about cross stitching much. So I think it would be good for you visually to see the canvases itself. So hold on for a second. Okay, I have here four different counts of Ada, and you probably can see that they not only different by the size but also by the color. And now to explain to you better what's the difference between sizing on Ada, you have to look this way. The smaller number, the bigger canvas crosses. So this is 11 count, this is 14, 16 count, and 18 count. So between this and this, you can see big difference. I never did cross stitching on 18, and I got this one. Here's the here. I got this from Walmart, I believe, maybe from Michaels. It was in this kind of packaging. So this one came like in a roll like this nicely. I think maybe from Walmart. So this one 18, and this is the smallest count that I have in my possession. But when I'm looking at right now, this one that I got cross stitching that I'm working on, this one 16 and this one 18. It doesn't really seems like big difference, and I don't know if I even can bring you more close so you can see the difference or not. Let's hope so, but I think you can tell. Maybe if I can, it would be good to have something colorful probably in the background, but I think you will see this way that 16 Aida a little bit bigger squares than 18. So the bigger number, the smaller crosses you will have on stitching. So this is what you have to remember. And this one, I would say it's already kind of challenging for my eyes, but I still can do it. I bought this one 18. I did not try to stitch on it yet, and the picture that I picked to work on it, this canvas is a little bit too small for me because I need a bigger one, and that's the one that Cinderella I want to do. Now between this one too, this one is 14 count, and let's compare to 16 count. I believe this is 14. I have this canvas for a long time, guys, and this is really visually, you can see in here that 14, definitely big difference. Now between 14 count and 11 count, in here also you will see difference. Let me get in one layer kind of like this. You see how much, even when you're looking on a holes on a canvas, you can see that it's bigger. And usually 11 count Aida, you have to stitch in 3 DMC threads. 14 count, you stitching in 2 DMC threads. Depends if you have a cotton, or depends on a design, sometimes could be stitched in 1 thread, but DMC definitely need to be in 2. But then, yeah, you can visually see very well in here that size are different. And if you are a beginner, I would suggest to start maybe on 11 count so you can see better. It will be easier for you to learn. Also for the beginners, I would suggest to start on a canvas that is pre-printed already, design, like I have this one, right? So you follow colors, you don't have to count anything, and it's just really easy to work with. You can watch movie, you can listen to TV, you can listen to your kids when they read a book or whatever they do in the house, and you're not gonna mistake, you just follow by the color, especially this canvases that printed from China. I really like them, and I do have few more that I already did my video unboxing, and I'm waiting one more in the mail that I order big canvas, and I think I ordered on a printed canvas, I hope so. I can't remember right now, could be counted, not sure. But I love from AliExpress canvases that it's already printed. It's so easy to follow and still have give you those details. They have even back stitching in here and mixed stitching, like a blending colors. So you can have a whole full experience on a cheap canvases like this. Usually you can order from AliExpress printed or not printed image. They give you choice what you can pick. The only thing, if you choose printed area, that could be like $3 or $4, a little bit more expensive, because obviously they have to use the ink to print image on your canvas. When you order just a blank canvas with the design on a printed booklet, that way a little bit cheaper. But if you are a beginner, spend some money and buy first your canvas on a 11 count stitch, and it's big canvas to work. It's so easy, and you don't even need the glasses if you wear one, because it's a big stitches in here. Even 14, I used to all my life stitch only on 14 count, and it's not as small either. Like, it's really easy to follow because it has a big holes up there. You can see clearly those what you're doing cross stitching. Like this one, I already say that I'm stitching for the first time. It's a little bit already challenging because it's really tiny stitching in here. But also you have to remember, if you stitch in picture, for example, like this one on 11 count, and this picture size, I can't remember right now if they have a size in here or not. Well, my mat, this one, has a centimeters measurement in here. I'm just gonna off the camera, guys, now measure 47 centimeters this way. So if you're doing the same picture on, say, 16 count, Ada, this picture will look much smaller. That's the only difference you will have if you stitch on a smaller canvas, like smaller number of Ada, which like 16 or 18, this picture will look much smaller than that would be look on 11, because of course you're cross stitching bigger and the picture will be spread out more bigger. If you stitch same picture on this canvas, this picture will be look, for example, if to compare them like this, right? And we can see this picture probably gonna end up being very tiny one, because it's a smaller stitches. I still will look good, still will look pretty, but you will need just a smaller frame, and it's just gonna look more cute. And you have to stitch in one or two threads, depends what idea of this design. So I hope this little bit tip will help you. And you have to remember, and guys, I got this one diamond paint, this cross stitch, I always put link under my video. I really like this one store, and the other ones that I order from AliExpress, I can link it up for you. And I cannot wait to get my other canvas that I'm waiting. Today I actually received my pack of diamond paintings. Oh, I know, it's scary to receive stuff now from China. I kind of disinfected them a little bit, packaging, but as somebody in my group tell me, you know, because it's so long time flying from China to Canada, the bacteria already dead. Well, thank you, that makes me feel good, feel better. So anyway, we live as we're supposed to live, that's all, don't afraid. Would I recommend right now order from China? I don't know. I would put probably on hold stuff, but I order my stuff long time ago and they traveling for a while, so who knows, right? Now what else I want to say? Yes, I finished my canvas last night, Dreamer Design 2.0 version of new releases, guys. It's so beautiful, I cannot wait to share with you. Unfortunately, I can't yet, because it's not in a store yet. So I have to keep this little bit secret away from you till my boss tell me that I can show it to you. For now, I just can't, because rule is a rule. But I did record that video already of my unboxing of work in progress, and my did not record up there my finished project. I will do that with the new video for Dreamer Design when I will unbox brand new canvas, not the one that I work, but I really satisfy what I was seeing on the end. So I think you're gonna love it. If you like me to stitch maybe with you a little bit, I will create separate video and we're gonna continue to do progress on this beautiful, beautiful image. Let I stitch, and just a reminder for my new viewers, this is the picture that we are working, and as I just told you, I always start from the corner. So this is the corner that I started, this little corner, actually like this. If I turn my canvas, this is corner, this is the grass, bushes, whatever I'm doing in here is supposed to be. So the picture itself gorgeous, and I hope it will look beautiful when I finish. So I hope this video will help to somebody who just started to cross stitch, guys. And all you have to remember, the lower number, then it's mean big crosses you will receive. The smallest number, 16, 18, it's mean it's harder to stitch. Its crosses will be much smaller. So remember that. Bigger number, smaller stitches. Lower number, bigger, more comfortable stitches. I will thank you right now for watching and listening. And please subscribe if you are new to my channel. And guys, my anniversary gonna be on January 31st. It's gonna be 2 or 3 years on my channel. Oh my God. let me pick up on my channel right now. I created my channel on January 31st, 2018. So yeah, it's gonna be 2 years. Very young channel. But I love you all. You are my biggest supporters, and without you, I wouldn't be able to create so many videos. Just your love and support, that's what make me going, and I'm really happy to have this family across the globe, guys. Thank you so much, and I will see you in my next DIY or tutorial video.